I'm just kidding, it's my listing. Let's get started. All right, guys, welcome to another episode of TLG Vlogs, and we are actually inspired today being in this beautiful brand new listing we have in Washington Township. The thought came to us, right? Like, you want to buy a brand new, gorgeous, beautiful house just like this one. Where do you start, right? On the market, maybe these options aren't available. Maybe on the market, this kitchen isn't the kitchen that you're absolutely in love with. Let's say you have that artistic side to you where you want to customize the whole house from top to bottom. Where, as the buyer, does that process start? So step number one, I'm going to sit down for this one, is going to be finding the location, right? So if I was a buyer right now and I was like, hey, honey, we want to go build a brand new house. Where does this process really procure and where does it start? So, number one, you have to make a very important decision. Number one, are you gonna find the property yourself? Are you gonna go out on the market? Are you gonna go skim through the listings? Are you gonna go find land cheap enough or a house maybe that's depreciated enough for you to go buy it at a good price, you know, and acquire that property to then line it up with the builder to be able to build it? Or are you gonna link up with the builder who may actually have the property where at that point you can customize? And that's why we're here today. All right, so now we've talked about the land, right? We talked about finding the land. So let's say you are the money conscious individual, right? You wanna save as much money as possible. So you think you wanna do the whole process completely by yourself, which people do. So here's some very, very important tips to know first. So if you are lucky enough and you find the perfect property that you're gonna purchase, right? Let's say you're not a cash buyer and you're gonna go get a loan on that property. Most banks, at least in today's guidelines, will not lend normal 5, 10, even 20% down on these products because you're essentially knocking the house down. So if you're buying a house to completely level and start over, it has to almost fall under an investment. So now you're gonna get into a product which may, you know, bear a little bit of a higher interest rate. You're gonna need a little more liquidity, right? Most of these banks wanna see at least 25% down. And then how are you gonna fund the construction of that project? So either you have to have line of credit, you have to have the bank gonna offer you a construction loan, or you have to have the cash on hand to be able to, you know, fund the project for the bank to be able to see that it's worth, you know, them giving you the loan to buy that property to basically knock it down or add to it or renovate it or whatever it may be. So that's probably the biggest thing that I talk to clients about on day one when they come to me and say, hey, Taylor, like, is it cheaper for me to go find the house myself and, you know, hire the builder after? Maybe it is, but you need some more liquidity. It takes a lot of time, energy, and you're gonna go through a totally different loan process than maybe the more seamless route, as I mentioned earlier, where maybe you found a builder who's already found the perfect property and you have to just link with that builder and feel comfortable with that builder, which we'll talk about in tip number two, to start the process and build that house. So that's a decision you as a consumer need to make. All right, honey, we made it, right? We found the perfect property in the perfect town. It's everything we've ever looked for, which I wanna talk about right now. So a lot of times, buyers will walk into a brand new house and have that wow factor, right? It's brand new, it's everything that you've been looking for, but it's really important. You'll hear me talk about it in anything educational-wise, whether it's on my blogs or whether it's in reels or just general conversations with buyers, that location is the biggest thing when buying a house because today it is a brand new house in an okay location. The last thing you want is one day it'll be an old house in an okay location. So location A plus is the first important tip. So now that you've gotten to the stage and you have the right property and you're in the right location, right? You have to find the builder that you feel super comfortable working with through the process. So how do you do that, right? So number one, I would always look at a builder's work. So with the internet and everything being digital and everything being online today, you have access to so much information. So I would do research in a certain town. So let's use Washington Township as an example where we're sitting right here today. So if I was looking to build a house in Washington Township, I would look through maybe 3 years worth of brand new inventory that's hit the market, right? Past sold. So I would look at all the builders that have built houses and I would find a product and a style that really fit maybe what my needs were. I'd contact that builder and I'd have to sit down in their office. That's step two. So now we have met the builder, we see a product that we like, and now it's time to build and design our dream home. Keyword, design your key home. So now it's Q&A time. You're the buyer, right? It's time to talk to the builder about everything that is involved in the process. So the first question I'd ask a builder, after working out deposit situations and structure of payment and who owns the land, who doesn't, is included in the package, does the builder have a full-time designer on staff? Right? How often can you talk to that designer on staff? Because designing a house is probably one of the most stressful elements to a buyer, right? Unless the builder's already designed it to what they think it is and you walk in and you love it. But remember, you're the artist, you're designing your own house. How often could you reach out to the designer? How many options do you have? Secondly, is there an architect on staff, right? Who are you working with? Doesn't have to necessarily be on staff, meaning working for the builder, and that's the same concept with the designer, but it has to mean they have some sort of network around that person that you have access to. Because quite often when someone's designing a house, especially on the floor plan end of things, right, it's very nitty gritty. So how many times can I reach out to the architect and make revisions, and what cost is that gonna come to me if I wanna change something 3 or 4 times before we get started? So these are all really, really important questions. Number three, you get the full package, right? You have an idea of what the estimated cost of the construction is going to be. You need a spec sheet, you need a budget sheet. What's your accounted for budget on kitchen? What's your accounted for budget on appliances? What's your accounted for budget on tile packages, right? And then I would basically run that budget right by the designer. You've asked the right questions. Maybe you're feeling slightly overwhelmed, but don't worry. You have the right builder. They have the arsenal of people around you that are gonna help you make these big decisions, right? Because the buyer, the first thing the buyer's constantly thinking about when they wanna design a house is, I wanna have my beautiful dream kitchen, I wanna have my beautiful dream bathroom, right? But let's talk about the things that maybe necessarily they're not thinking about, right? So, I mean, the first thing I would think about is, you know, being in the business would be, you know, how about lighting fixtures? How about, you know, bathroom fixtures? How about lighting packages? How about trim packages? How about molding packages? I'm totally just sitting here. But the reason is I'm trying to de-stress this video for you guys. I'm trying to make you think how easy this process is if you hire the right team from day one, let the professionals do what they do best. Everybody gets so overwhelmed with the picking of certain tiles and different attributes of the house that let the professional do what they do best. Let them package together. Let them, you know, design your furniture package. Let them design your fireplace. And you know what? The fun part is picking it out and enjoying the house. All right, you made it to this stage, right? We're at the finish line, almost, but the foundation to any good relationship, no matter what it is, whether it's in business or design or in friendship, whatever, is communication, right? The point is have open lines of communication with whoever you're working with, from the design team to the architect to the builder to whoever you're working with through the process, and have a really good establishment of all the questions answered up front, right? The devil always lies in the details. Not having the answers to the things up front before you get started is always the underlying issue why things go wrong. So my biggest tip I can give you guys today would be ask all the important questions up front. Nothing's a stupid question. Find someone that's willing to work with you and help you design this dream home. And of course, like I've been mentioning over and over and over, work with professionals through the process. Work with a great real estate broker. Work with a great mortgage lender. Work with a great builder. Work with a great design team. Work with a great architect. Work with the right people. It makes the process totally seamless and worth it in the end. Hope these tips help. See you guys on another episode of TLG Vlogs. And thank you as always. Subscribe if you like this. See you guys next week. Bye.